big full of
Well, good evening, and with protocol being so eloquently established by our moderator, our administrator, let's give him a hand. I would like to begin by thanking each of you that have taken time out of your evening to witness the ceremony and to join us here on this most auspicious occasion. Your presence has made this evening even more special. And although protocol has been established, I must recognize the Parliamentary Secretary for Tourism and Aviation and our Member of Parliament, the Honorable John Pinder. He served with us in the last term in local government as the Deputy Chief Counselor and made a meaningful contribution. Mr. Pinder and I met yesterday for an hour, and we discussed many things with regard to our district, and he is truly advocating for our communities, and as a council, we look forward to working with him to make a positive impact within our district, and he will be meeting in short order with our entire council, and let's give him a hand and thank him for joining us. We meet here at this time and place, taking a solemn oath to fulfill our duties as councilors and to serve our communities to the best of our abilities. We take this obligation freely, and we do so with a spirit of serving others and improving our municipal jurisdiction. I have to take time for a moment just to salute those who served this past term, and I would like to name each one, if you just give me a minute. Other than myself, Councilors Aciel, McDonald, Arthur Eldon, Don Cash, Deborah Patterson, Sinead Turnquest, Laverty, and as I mentioned, our very own MP, John Pinder. This past term was the most trying time to serve on council, and it was the most trying time for everyone for that matter. We sought to do all that we could in our capacity as councilors in the aftermath of that monster storm Dorian. Obviously limited by a tight budget, we did what we could, whether it was allocating funding to repair the roofs of some of our public buildings or handing out fuel and food vouchers to residents. We did our very best with the little that we had to bring relief to you, our constituents. And although we served on council, we honestly shared in the pain that everyone was going through because many of us were dealing with the same pain personally. I know John Pinder lost his hand, or most of it, in the storm. I had a fair amount of internal damage to my hand, so did Arthur Eldon. Don Cash also had pretty much rebuilt his hand. And then apart from that, I'd just like to mention, and this is going away from what my prepared statement, but my mind goes back to the scenes right after that terrible time when, just days after the storm, it didn't matter how rich you were or how poor you were, we were all in the same boat. Mm-hmm. And I remember right down there at Manoa Grocery, Aciel McDonald and Manoa Grocery opened up their doors to the community. And I could remember just about the entire community was out in the word when they were going to do that. And in saying that, you know, they also, in saying that, I'd like to compliment Aciel for all he did in that time at Manoa Grocery, and let's give them a hand. But also during that time, like many businesses, they had to rebuild their businesses, so that was taking a lot of his personal time as well. But I'm saying, despite our personal loss, whether it was our homes or businesses, you know, we did all that we could whilst going through these major issues to try to carry on the business of local government during this period in our history. And then, as we all know, we had the double whammy with COVID, and our council had to deal with operating through a pandemic. But I would like to thank again all the previous councilors who served. Let's give them a hand. And we have a great team going into this new term, and I'm excited at what can be achieved as we move forward. In Oaktown, our new Deputy Chief Counselor, Frank Knowles, is a successful real estate agent. And he and his wife have been successful with their business, Advocates and other ventures. Frank has also served as a consultant in the past year for the district council. He is clearly a leader and a key component to the success of this team. Let's give him another hand. Todd Cash, grandson of former Commissioner Rispolo. You know I like my genealogy. Todd's start in local government has continued his family's commitment to service at the local level. Apart from his maternal grandfather, Rispolo, his father, Roy Cash, was a former deputy chief counselor, and more recently, his uncle, Don Cash, had served on the district council for 9 years. Todd is the owner of a reputable construction company in Oaktown, and his expertise in construction will be valued as we consider the many time planning applications that come before us. Let's give him a hand. Junior Menard is someone that is a man of many hats, and I've known Junior for quite some time. Working for many years in the hospitality industry, working at a marina, setting up his own golf cart business, and as a realtor, Junior is truly a people's person, and I am confident he will attend to the needs of his constituents with great passion. He is a welcome addition to the council, and we are lucky that he is on our team. Moving into Manor War, Aciel McDonald is now serving his third term, and he has been a valuable asset to this council with his previous knowledge of local government procedure. And I have always said it is good to have business leaders in politics, even if it is just the town council. Aciel's viewpoints that he brings to the table in different situations regarding community issues that arise in our meetings is valuable. His input and advice gets all of us thinking deeply, and I have counted on him many, many times in different ways. I am, as many of you know, I'm off the island at work days, and he has caught the brunt of community concerns, phone calls on issues, and being that he is here on the ground. And I don't say it often enough, but I am very thankful, especially serving as chief counselor, and sometimes having to attend different functions off island or on the mainland. And he's right here in Manor where we have a very dedicated and faithful, hardworking counselor in the person of Aciel McDonald, and he is very much a part of what makes this council a success. Let's give him a hand. Well, I can't say that Fred Sweeting is new to local government. He did serve almost a year back in 2007, 2008, and he also grew up around local government as his father and my uncle, as was mentioned previously, former Chief Counselor Walter Sweeting served between the Board of Works and local government for 16 years. And of those years, he served as Chief Counselor for this council from 2002 to 2005 and done an exemplary job. Let's give Uncle Walter a hand.
Interrupt you, Jeremy. We're 14 days apart. We were born. Thank God you didn't tell them more what we've done together.
But as for Fred, he will also bring stellar representation to Manor War Key and the district as a whole. And one thing is certain, if Fred believes in something and it's a cause that you are fighting for, there's no one better than I have in your corner. We welcome him to this team. And last, but certainly by no means the least, we have Great Warner Keys. Great, I have to say great. Everybody, a lot of times they correct me down at Warner Keys, but I don't have the Great Warner Keys Councilor Willis Laverty. We had a short and formal meet and greet on Monday at the Abaco Inn for all of the incoming councilors. And the amount of visitors that knew Willis and came up and embraced him and spoke with him in the short time he was there had never stopped, and I told him he was quite a celebrity. But Willis is a giant in the hospitality industry, much loved by all who knows him. He is taking over as counselor for Warner Keys, succeeding his own daughter-in-law, Shanae, who served in the previous term. In the few minutes speaking with Willis on Monday, I admire his passion and his strive to get moving with the many needs of Warner Keys, and I have no doubt that the people of Warner Keys are the right man for the right time. And Willis' strong motivation has impressed us. And by the time this term comes to an end, I am convinced that Willis Laverty will no doubt be a counselor par excellence. And let's give him a hand. And I'd like to pay a compliment to our administrator. He has been a delight to work with, and we have a great working relationship, and he shows absolute professionalism as he carries out his day-to-day duties and responsibilities within the office of administrator. Let's give our administrator a round of applause. One thing that the pandemic taught us was the fact that the municipal and local governments worldwide are expected to find ways to continue to function and operate in the midst of a pandemic while delivering basic services to the local communities. We will endeavor to do whatever we can to ensure that essential services are carried out in timely fashion during these uncertain times. And one thing that Dorian showed us, and I'm getting ready to end, is that we are a resilient people that cannot be completely broken, that we will never, never give up. And with a dynamic council that you see here, and teaming with our constituents, and with that great spirit, there's nothing that we cannot conquer. And we have a great team and a great opportunity to accomplish great things. I wish to thank councilors for their confidence reposed in me by electing me yet again as chief councilor. I pledge to all of you that I will try and live up to the sacred trust and to be the leader you expect me to be, and with us working hand in hand and together as a team, this council will continue to be regarded as the hallmark of local government bodies within the length and breadth of this great Commonwealth. Thank you, and God bless all Bahamas.